Early jab here from Bruno Pucci. Another jab from the Brazilian. Outside leg kick. Nice counter right hand from Pucci. Gorobets almost eating that right hand down the center corridor. Another jab there from Bruno.
Bruno's got to be careful. He's got to get his head moving, keep that head offline. Right now his head's very stationary, and he's standing right in front of Gorobets.
Oh, nicely done. A little fake with the right hand. Moved in for a double leg takedown. Sprawled out, though, did Gorobets to defend, and he's out of trouble.
Yeah, good defense from Gorobets. Dug those underhooks, was able to create separation. That's a nice little confidence booster for Gorobets, keeping it on the feet. Gorobets says that he regularly submits BJJ black belt, so he has no problem going to the ground with Pucci. But he does want to keep this thing on the ground and continually test that chin.
Bruno needs to be careful not to get too wild with the hands. Looks for the inside leg kick. Right down the center corridor there from Gorobets. Nicely placed to the orbital.
Yeah, Bruno's got to be careful. He's a little bit flat-footed now. He's got to start moving that head. Get that head offline. You can see that swelling that's starting to build up on the left side of Bruno Pucci's head.
Attempted takedown again from Bruno Pucci. Backs Gorobets against the wire here. Looking for a takedown, the Brazilian.
Good job pressing Gorobets up against the wall here. He's got the double underhooks. He's working for it. You can see Gorobets has got a nice deep underhook on his right side. He's going to try to pull Pucci up, but Pucci's got the legs locked, and he likes these trips.
Turns Pucci against the fence now. Does Kirill Gorobets.
Good job by Gorobets to turn Pucci around, press him up against the wall. Now he's kind of using a knee shield to prevent Pucci from wrapping his legs up. Pucci likes to trip, right? He likes to create that outside reap and create angles where he can drag him down.
A real joust inside the first round with 2:45 remaining.
Oh, Gorobets
still
gets strong.
To go to ground.
Gorobets strong inside that clinch. Pucci's digging. This is a good opportunity for Pucci right here. He's got both hands clasped around the body. And we've seen earlier that Christian Lee likes these reaps. He likes these rips. He likes to pull things down. And Pucci's been working on those same types of trips.
Knees to the hamstring area from Bruno Pucci to that left leg of Gorobets.
Pucci tried to step across. Now he's working his way to the back. Let's see if Gorobets can utilize that whizzer on his left side to keep this position standing, or is Pucci going to be able to get him to the ground?
Lots of instructions coming from the corner of Gorobets.
Good balance by Gorobets so far to keep things upright.
Still yet to affect a takedown here. Bruno Pucci tries to sink a double.
Good job by Gorobets to split the grip of Pucci. You can see how Pucci's trying to clasp his hands together. And Gorobets is about to go full splits here as he's trying to prevent Pucci from locking his hands up.
He may have to go full Van Damme here in a moment.
He's pretty close to doing it right now. He's got some really flexible hip flexors right now to get that deep on it. But a good job utilizing the whizzer. See his left hand's going to the overhook. He's trying to pry him up, keeping him upright. He's doing a good job of it.
Little hook off the break there from Bruno Pucci. 1:15 remaining. Now the applause from the crowd that continues to file into the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Overhand left there from Gorobets. Snaps out the jab. Not connecting though.
Yeah, let's see if Pucci can get that jab going. Pucci's got a nice, stiff, straight jab. He needs to utilize it. Especially if he wants to create that entry, right? He's got to put the hands together and disguise the shot a little bit better.
Remember, Pucci did say that Gorobets throws wild. And as a result of that, Gorobets leaves gaps. That's what Pucci wants to find, the gap in the defense of Kirill Gorobets. Pucci comes forward, right hand lead, takes a glancing left hook.
Yeah, Pucci likes leading with that right hand.
Body shot to the head there from Gorobets. Overhand right to the left hook for the Ukrainian. Now studies up the power. Uppercut catches Pucci.
Pucci's landing some big shots on Gorobets. Gorobets is landing big shots on Pucci with some massive hand combinations. Like, he's got to push. I think he's going to let him out of this round.
High left round. Overhand prime. Pucci wore that one. Gorobets with the heavy artillery in the final seconds of this round. And we go to the towels after one. Wherever you're watching, folks, let us know your thoughts at ONE Championship on social media as we see a nice jab two combination there from Kirill Gorobets, tagging Pucci on the orbital.
Look at these combinations thrown by Gorobets. That one narrowly missed the mark, but a beautiful little follow-up left hook right there. And then he pushed forward, landed an uppercut, narrowly missed on the left hand again.
Good. Wreck his thighs a little bit. When you have him pinned, lean, sharp, short and sharp. And then look at, once he starts turning, look to make the turn. Okay? They're not gonna give you as much time on the fence, so you gotta work. All right, let's go.
Instructions there from Master Ken Lee. We rock and roll in the second round, set for three. Judged as an overall 15-minute match. First fight of our lead card of 1-163, Akimoto versus Pet Lenong from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Gorobets landing some heavy leather in the final 15 seconds of the opening stanza.
You can hear Ken Lee telling Bruno Pucci to wreck his thighs. I think he wants him to go after and use those leg kicks. Pucci's got heavy leg kicks. I felt him before. He's got good, strong leg kicks, and he needs to utilize them. He needs to put some hand combinations together and then start throwing those leg kicks.
Right hand leads to a wild left hook from Gorobets, shakes it off. Pucci tries a left hook of his own.
Because right now, Gorobets is starting to tee off on him. He's really loading up on these punches, putting a lot behind him. Pucci has to earn some respect.
I liked when Bruno was sitting behind that flicking jab at the start of the round, first round.
Got a really good jab. He just needs to believe in it. Nice little calf kick landed by Gorobets.
Gorobets constantly moving around here, not remaining a stagnant target for Bruno to pick off. Edges for the Ukrainian. There's that overhand right to the left eyebrow.
That one touched Bruno on the chin. Slapped his head around.
Bruno again looking for a takedown. Gorobets just ragdolls him. Left hook from the Ukrainian, then to the abdomen.
That was good defense by Gorobets. Got the underhook and then just whipped him around.
Jab from Gorobets. Striking, looking good for the Ukrainian. But will he offer Bruno those gaps? There's another stiff jab to the beard of Bruno Pucci. You can hear the instructions from the Ukrainian's corner. Double jab to right hand. Nice combination again from Kirill. Oh, with that left hand. Bruno tried to counter with a hook.
Dude, he's getting touched with that right hand. That's the second massive right hand that Bruno's been hit with. Third one. Oh.
Bruno's got to take him down. Yeah. Chance for the knees.
Good move by Bruno to clinch up, slow this onslaught down with the knee to the body, Michael.
Almost folded him in half with that right knee. Bruno's got to find a way to get Gorobets horizontal. Right hand lead from the Ukrainian, dances out of the way of a counter.
Yeah, that right hand just can't miss right now from Gorobets.
Bruno backs him off with a left. Left hook working a treat though for Gorobets.
When Bruno opens up a little bit, you can see his hand comes down and his left hand is dropping down by his waist. And that's that right hand lead coming from Gorobets. And he keeps touching Bruno on the side of his face.
Drop that one to the sternum, did Gorobets.
But Bruno did answer a lot of questions about his chin. He's taking a lot of big shots and he's hanging in there.
No doubt. Bruno shoots in for a double, spools out to Gorobets. Defending the takedown attempt again. We are yet to go to ground in this one with 1:50 remaining in the second.
Yeah, Bruno needs to change the way that he's getting these takedowns, right? He gets into the body lock, but there's no change, right? There's no change of wrestling from there. He's got to put combinations together with his chain wrestling. He's got to drop down to a single leg, move around, because Gorobets has kind of got his number for this one. Let's see if he can do it. Good balance showcase by Gorobets.
Fence there. Referee Herb Dean just telling both men to keep working here as Bruno tries to dig a left hand into the body. What are the options here for Bruno, Mitch?
Well, he's got one of those arms trapped, right? So his right arm is kind of stuck right there. Now he's dropping down. He's he's just fallen in love with this double leg takedown, especially once he gets the hands locked. Usually people go for a ride when Bruno Pucci gets his hands locked together, but Gorobets is doing a beautiful job of digging the underhooks and keeping this thing standing.
And Pucci. You were talking about a man with 170 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu career wins, a two-time no-gi BJJ world champion, Bruno Pucci.
Yeah, but right now, none of that stuff's helping him, Michael. He's got a...
Oh, that's it. That floored him, that right hand. Bruno in trouble now. Half-guard position for Gorobets. With
he
under 30 seconds remaining, here come the hammer fists. Hurting may stop it. Defending, can he get out of the round?
Wow, Bruno did a good job of defending right there. He got caught with a few of them, but utilized the guard well, maintained space, but he ate some massive shots. And Herb Dean let him work. Look at Gorobets just driving his forearm right into the neck of Pucci.
Bruno locking him down with that figure four, wisely so. And he survives the round. Does Bruno Pucci. We'll go to his corner in a moment, see what Ken Lee has to say.
Man, watch this right hand. Boom, right on the money, sends Pucci for the ride. But to Pucci's credit, he stays in there, eats a lot of shots, but watch this, just comes right through the middle. See, when Pucci opens up, that's when he's exposing that side of his face, and Gorobets is just tattooing it.
Let's go. Nothing reckless. Hands up. Build in. Pressure him. He's going to load. He's going off of one beat now. You're stepping in the one beat range. That means you got to go first. If you want to get a little air, you got to stay in the two beat range and jump on it, right? A little bit too close with that.
Nothing wild, says Ken Lee. They know that Gorobets is going to be hunting for a knockout here in the third and final round. Can Pucci tighten up? Can Pucci get Gorobets to the canvas? He has tried several times, has been unsuccessful. But you can never rule out the Pucci ball.
Especially if you can get this to the ground. One good takedown, enters into the single, transitions to that double leg. Pucci can get you out of there if he starts grappling with you. But right now, he's got to do something about that right hand of Gorobets.
Pucci closing the distance. Looks for another takedown attempt here.
Yeah. Gorobets does a beautiful job of making sure that his right hand is on the inside when Pucci takes these body lock takedowns, right? So he can create that separation. Here he's got that, you can see him, he's fighting for that hand position right now. He's trying to create separation on the hands, dig his hand underneath so he can pry him up.
It is seemingly all for Bruno Pucci to do in the next 4 minutes and 10 seconds.
It's that left-hand wizard. See how he created separation with that? He drove his elbow into the arm of Pucci, got the separation, and now he starts hand fighting.
Nice little uppercut off the left hand there from Pucci. Turns Gorobets against the fence here. Does Bruno.
Gorobets is just using the wall as just a support lever, right? So he can just balance there. He's doing really good anti-wrestling against the cage. Bruno does a good job of getting the leg trapped. Right now he's got his leg trapped in between his others. Now Pucci can spin really hard down. The Gorobets just turns him around. Good job by Pucci to press him up against the wall again. Driving his head right underneath the chin, trying to create that position. Pucci drops down for the single. Gorobets has got such good takedown defense though.
Can Bruno Pucci get a takedown? It would turn this match around. He needs it. Startless shots off the left hand, and Herb Dean is going to separate them. He wants to see more action.
Pucci worked hard to get in that position. He has to be a little bit more active next time. He has to be changing, right? Chaining rest takedowns together.
Right hand lead from Gorobets. You sense the confidence oozing through the Ukrainian right now. Two-punch combination from Kirill. Pucci, good sneaky uppercut off the lead hand. Dances out of the way. Gorobets with the left hand, didn't come close. single punches here from Gorobets. Needs to go back to those combinations. Right hand lead from Bruno, left the left hand down.
Yeah, when Bruno goes forward, he's having more success. It's just when he gets caught stuck with his back up against the wall that Gorobets is able to unload on him.
Stiff jab from Bruno off the back foot.
Yeah, there's that jab you were talking about, Michael. He's got to let that jab go.
And the left hook is starting to find range now. Needs a little more mustard from Bruno, but it's getting there. 2 minutes remaining.
The jab needs to be that first combination of trying to pick that lock, right? He's just got to keep putting that out there.
That hook's there. It's landing. Just needs more power. More torque.
It's hard after, you know, 12 minutes.
No doubt.
After a long layoff. Oh, good job by Pucci to get tight, though. This is where he wants it. Let's see if he can do anything with his half guard.
1 minute 30 remaining.
He's thinking about triangling the leg right there, maybe go into a lockdown position, just kind of hold him there, and then able to advance. But Gorobets has really good ground and pound from the half guard position.
What can the two-time no-gi BJJ world champion do from off his back here?
Not sure why Pucci's choosing to go with a body triangle here. He needs to be a little bit more offensive in his attack on the guard, right? He can't just lie there, especially with 1 minute to go. He needs to be going for arm bars. He needs to be going for triangles. Now he's got his foot on the hip. Now Pucci can start working.
45 seconds on the clock now. Again, that triangling of the body from Bruno Pucci opens up the guard a little more. Cracking elbow, look to the side of the face from Gorobets. Pucci closes the guard. Left hand connects to Kirill. Working well off the top from inside Pucci's guard. Time against Bruno here. Has Bruno Pucci got something left, something special, something magical in the last 10 seconds? Body head Gorobets. We are going to go down to the judges, it looks like. Gorobets back to his feet, takes the back. Looks for a high knee. And indeed, we are going to a decision.
Yeah, really. Slick performance from Kirill Gorobets. Showcased really good stand-up. Tough takedown defense, able to keep this match on the feet, but it was this right hand, man. Look at that. Boom. Came right down the middle, was able to touch Bruno over and over again with that monstrous right hand. But to Bruno's credit, he stood in there, eating a lot of big, heavy shots. Zero quit in the Pucci Bowl, but Kirill Gorobets was just too much for him tonight.
Plenty more action coming your way, folks, on this lead card of 1-163. Up next, it will be Melina Sakamoto versus Bianca Basilio in a strawweight submission grappling contest. Also, big Bruno Chavez and Ahmed Kurnic meet in the main fight of our lead card. Coming up later on, a heavyweight kickboxing stoush. As the judges are tabulating their scorecards, and I see Dom Lau now stepping into the circle, which means we have our results. Let's go to Dom and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Kirill Gorobets!